I don't know if all of you are aware of the Civic Apps Initiative. Who here has heard of it? Yeah, lots of folks. Awesome. So the city, and actually in a collaboration with Greater Portland, some of the metro agencies, has taken all of these awesome data sets that they've had, a lot of it associated with portlandmaps.com, and released them. And they're trying to get folks to hack on these, find new ways of sharing that data, new ways of collaborating with the city through that data. And Mayor Sam Adams is spearheading this activity along with a bunch of other awesome folks that are here today. And he's here, of course, to talk about many things that the city is doing in relation to the software community here in Portland, and also just to kick off a day of hacking on this data. So I hope, you know, if you have some time today, there are people that specifically are here. I know about 25 people that specifically are here today to hack on that stuff. But if at any time during the day you want to check that out, I know that Leslie Hawthorne, raise your hand, Leslie, is helping coordinate some of this activity. And of course, folks from the city, Rick and Skip and the mayor. But anyway, so I want to invite the mayor now to come up and talk to us a little bit about this. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Oh, yeah, I need the mic. Oh, yeah. Well, good morning, everybody. I long suspected that folks in this area of endeavor survived on caffeine, donuts, and beer. And based on the program notes, I now have it confirmed. So I also know walking in, a number of you have told me that this is not your prime time of day, necessarily. So I will consider my remarks a success if nobody actually falls out of their chair as they nod off. But I am very, very excited to be here again. Our interaction at the last conference helped inspire me to work with our great group of technologists in the city of Portland to have the city lead a regional effort to get us in the forefront of open source and open data with Portland city government. And I want to acknowledge some of those folks in follow-up to my time with you last time that have really, they're at the vanguard of open government, open source, open data. We have Mark Greinke, who's the Director of Technology for the city of Portland, Rick Nixon, who's been his right-hand person for all the civic apps work, and then is Philip here somewhere? Philip back there, who's leading innovation, and then Skip Newberry on the policy side in my office. Folks, they work really, really, really hard, and give them a round of applause because they've earned it. Now, when we got together last time, you in the Q&As asked for us to lead in the area of open source, and I want to report on that in some detail, although I think many of you already know what we're up to based on earlier sessions. But you also asked for city government to help in terms of being a early client of work that comes out of this area, to buy products that were generated locally, and to have city government be the first client, not the second, third, or fourth client after all the bugs are worked out. So I'll report a little bit on that. You also, we were heading into a recession, or actually it was full honest last time I met with you, and you also asked for financial assistance, that this was industry and endeavor that had a hard time scaling up because lack of first client, lack of capital, and I'll report on what we've done in that area. But before I do that, I want to just share with you a little bit more about Civic Apps. It's an opportunity for us to change the very relationship between a government, in this case, governments plural, and the people that we serve. Not only in the convenience of finding what, allowing, giving people tools to find what they want when they want it, but also in terms of accountability. And the citizen reporter that was done in-house with the city of Portland is a small example of that. We, for the first time, get pictures of potholes, and we get the exact coordinates of where they're at, and people, at least on one platform, can submit that to us in an integrated software system that then reports back to the customer or the person submitting it whether or not it got done. And I can't tell you how satisfied people who have access to this app are to be able to get that little notification back that says it was done. And they can see it for themselves if they go back to the incident or the problem that they reported. But that sense that government reported back to them, in addition to doing the work, has been, you know, for me, a surprisingly small step, but a huge source of satisfaction for Portlanders that have had access to this. Our biggest challenge has been, and our biggest complaint has been, to offer that kind of customer service on more platforms. And so we're working on that. Our great technology department, prioritized that in an in-house effort to sort of prime the pump. And it is, I know you're going to be focusing on other opportunities to put good data to work. We are obviously, with your partnership, trying to take this much further. The Civic Apps program has gotten a lot of national attention because it's regional. It's not just one city. And it's gotten a lot of recognition for being regional because we're not that unique. There are 60,000 people who live in the region that work in the city of Portland but don't live in the city of Portland. And so a lot of the other data sets that have been released across the country have been for one jurisdiction. And we've worked really hard to work across jurisdictional lines with TriMet and Metro and others and really offer open data that's really much more realistic to the daily life of folks in this region. We have no shame, or very little shame. We've been offering, as you know, contests for anyone who wins, and at the end of the month, one of you could be a lucky winner of a year-long TriMet pass, among other things. I just made that up, Mark. Better fulfill it. The area, if I could pitch you on that, we need a lot of work, and there've been. I've looked at the ideas that are submitted. The area of city government especially, but of all local government, that remains a significant mystery to citizens is the actual workings, decision-making workings. You know, someone submitted an idea around trying to make more useful real-time in English sort of apps around city council, for example, Portland City Council, issues being considered. Well, every city council agenda can have anywhere from 60 to 150 items on it. And it remains to most Portlanders, and this is true for city governments and county governments around the region, a complete mystery how work actually gets done. So if I could pitch you on anything, and there are a lot of great ideas there, I would pitch you on something that makes the actual decision making easier but more understandable to citizens. Since we last met, we've done more than just sort of have a collection of individual sort of silos of innovation. We've also sought to surround that with an economic development strategy. And for the first time in 14 years, the council adopted just that, an economic development strategy that has digital development as one of the four target industries that we focus on. And what does that mean? It means we'll help any business that matches the basic values of our city. But when we have proactive time, instead of every morning getting up and deciding the priority of the day, we've done our research. And we looked at what local assets do we have that match the fastest growth trends, economic growth trends, in the years ahead, both regionally, nationally, and growth trends around the globe. And that's why digital development became a target industry. Our value proposition in this area, we're not Silicon Valley, and frankly, we don't want to be in many ways. We offer a much better quality of life than Silicon Valley. But, yes. But where we can compete and win on a proportional basis with places like Silicon Valley is we have a more diverse group of technology folks here. We have clearly a smaller, but especially around software, we have a greater diversity of different kinds of talents, approaches than almost any place else in the world. We're also incredibly, this industry group is also incredibly agile. And the passion here, because you've had to kind of fight to sort of be recognized and sort of from a grassroots basis, in many ways, self-help, sort of helping each other, we're also really quick. We work together better than a lot of other industries, local industries of this nature. And that is the core of how we're going to succeed. One example is this civic apps and this partnership between government and folks like you. That's how we compete and that's how we succeed. And the talent here is amazing and we want to support it. So let's talk a little bit about how we can help you and other talented folks succeed. The recession that we're in has been a credit crunch. We've seen a lot of businesses go under in all industries. This particular industry, software especially, portion of this industry, has actually done pretty darn good compared to other industries during this recession. It doesn't mean that folks in the real world haven't been severely impacted, but we've done okay. There are worse places. In response to this, though, barrier of lack of resources, lack of access to capital to bring the best ideas to market and then to scale them up, we put together the Portland Startup Seed Business Fund. And that came as a direct request out of the software industry. And it has been capitalized at $250,000. We have private sector matching contributions. And now, this year in my budget, even though we've had to cut the heck out of city government, we put another $250,000 in it. And you can, if you haven't heard about it in detail, you can just go online at mayorsamadams.com and find ways that you can access it. The other thing that we're working on is with the Portland Development Commission. We have funded the Portland 10, which is a boot camp that works with 10 startups. Yes. And our goal is for those, so there's access to capital. Now it's also access to capital and the very best, getting you connected with the very best thinkers that we can gather from around the world. And then helping you, sometimes tough love, that's why we call it boot camp, but helping these 10 startups or 10 individuals or firms or ideas to get to $1 million a year in revenue. So we're really trying to, and again, this came out of when asking you all and other folks in the industry, what can city government do, what can the Portland Development can do to help. And so these open source startup capital funding and then the boot camp, which is funding with the best mentorships associated with that, all comes out of the kind of feedback that we're getting. And speaking of feedback, we really are interested in helping the industry based on what you say you need. And so you'll have an opportunity, if you haven't already, to be contacted by email or other forms of communications to take a survey. And we really need you to spend that 7 minutes of filling out that very boring, maybe, and dry survey, because that will help us over the next year to take what we've done together and make sure that we're working on the kinds of things in partnership with all of you that will make you all successful. I am incredibly enthusiastic and excited about what you are doing. And I want to thank the organizers of this great conference for everything that they've done. We are just at the very beginning of reaching our potential. And you can count on me as your mayor to do everything I can, working with my team, to see that you are very, very successful. I want you to take over the world from your base here in Portland. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you so much. All right, so like I said, Leslie, the mayor pointed out, there are a lot of city folks here today. They're all here to talk to you about what's going on with civic apps, for you to ask questions, to hack on things. There are several people here that have been working on projects as well, like PDX API, which is super cool, that came here with ideas to hack on. There's actually a mailing list as well. I think Leslie has that information, but it's just a Google group that you can subscribe to and chat about things that are going on. But anyway, it's a great project, and I hope that you find some time today to hack with folks. And Leslie, did you want to make any other announcements? Oh, yeah. All right. Rick Nixon, everyone.
Thank you. Now I feel really tall.
I think you probably do.
Okay. All right. So, yeah. First of all, thanks again to Open Source Bridge and the opportunity to be here for the first ever Civic Code Day. We plan to have a number of these, hopefully, throughout the contest and beyond. Again, my name is Rick Nixon. I'm the project manager for Civic Apps, and my job essentially is to make Civic Apps happen. That's been it so far. Today we have a number of people here that are in support of the Hackfest. Let's see, Viviana and Tim McHugh of TriMet. If you would just wave, please, so everybody can see you. Philip Holmstrand in the back from the city of Portland. He likewise is responsible for lots of data at the city, so he's a good guy to know. Steve Erickson of Metro. He is responsible for much of the Metro data. Court Buchholz from Single Mind Consulting. He is basically the developers of the Civic Apps website, and he's put in lots of effort and has gone way beyond the call of duty in support of this effort. As the mayor described, the purpose of Civic Apps is to support a new type of relationship between government and citizen developers. Essentially, the role of government, hopefully, will be to supply data. The role of citizens will be to do something with that data. It's also worth mentioning there's an underlying effort that is, you know, beginning to happen now, where I'm actually seeking to transfer the effort itself to the citizens of the greater Portland area. That means, you know, we're going to open source the website and a number of other things involved with doing that, which we're here to explore as well. So with that, that's pretty much everything I had to say, and we'll be available all day until 4:30 or so. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Rick. We'll be right back.